Hi there, my name is Clayton Anderson, and I am a retired United States astronaut. Now buckle up, future space explorers. It's time to blast off with an astronaut as we explore the ABCs of outer space with the Association of Space Explorers. Godspeed, everyone.
Hi, I'm Pierre Thuot. I'm a retired NASA astronaut, and I'm going to be talking to you today about the book A is for Astronauts. And I'm going to read something from the page S for Spacesuits. But before I do that, let me tell you a little bit about myself. I was born in Groton, Connecticut, and I grew up in Fairfax, Virginia. I went to the Naval Academy, and after I graduated there, I flew F-14s in the Navy before being selected for NASA as an astronaut in 1985. While at NASA, I flew on three space shuttle missions, the first one on Atlantis on STS-36, the second one on the space shuttle Endeavour on STS-49, and the third one on the space shuttle Columbia in 1994. So let me talk to you a little bit about spacesuits and spacewalks. Working outside in space is sure to impress. We call it a spacewalk, and its letter is S. Floating weightless with tools and a bulky white suit, we can fix and install things. It's really a hoot. Astronauts perform spacewalks for many reasons. They can install new equipment or fix things that are broken. An American spacewalk usually lasts about 6.5 hours, and the astronauts work in pairs to help each other keep safe. Big jobs need them to work together as a two-person team, but sometimes they do smaller jobs individually, always talking to one another to maintain awareness and check in. When going into and working in space, different suits are used for different tasks. The suit worn during launch and landing is called the ACES, Advanced Crew Escape Spacesuit System, and it is bright orange in color. It protects astronauts in the event of an emergency situation. For spacewalks, the suit is quite different, much heavier and colored bright white. It becomes your own personal spaceship and tools storage device while you work in the vacuum of space. So one thing you might be interested on is when we get stressed to go do a spacewalk, we don't just put on that big white suit on. The first thing we put on is a diaper. Yes, astronauts wear diapers. Then the second thing we put on is this liquid cooling and ventilation garment. It's a garment that has 300 feet of tubing that run through it that chilled water is pumped through to keep us cool. Because when we're doing a spacewalk, the temperature gets from plus 250 degrees Fahrenheit to minus 250 degrees Fahrenheit. So it's very cold, very hot. Of course, we orbit the Earth every 90 minutes, so we go through 16 daytime cycles and 16 nighttime cycles a day. So this is called the LCVG, Liquid Cooling and Ventilation Garment. Now, when we train for spacewalks, we spend a lot of time in a big swimming pool because we can simulate zero gravity in that swimming pool. So here I am, I'm getting suited up in the spacesuit I'm going to use in the water tank or in the swimming pool. Now, the reason we go in the water is because we can have put weights on our suit, on our arms and our legs and our backpack to make sure we don't sink to the bottom and then we don't float up to the top. So when we're just floating there at one level, that's neutral buoyancy, neutral buoyant, which is like neutral gravity or zero gravity. So it simulates pretty well neutral gravity or zero gravity in space. The big difference, though, is in space, there's no water, there's no air. So when we move around, there's no resistance. And I know you guys have experienced this when you're in a pool. In the summertime when you have to push the water out of the way. It's very resistant. It takes a lot of effort to swim and stuff like that. Well, that can actually disguise things for us for when we go do a spacewalk because there's no water resistance in space. So some things we learn in the water tank aren't so good. Here's a picture of me in the water tank with one of the scuba divers who help us out whenever we're doing our training. One thing you notice here is there's a line here, it's a tether, because whenever we're doing a spacewalk, we're always tethered to either the space station or the space shuttle, and that's because if for some reason we lose our grip, we're not going to fall down, we're going to float, and we're going to float away. And if we didn't have this tether attached to us, we could float away for a long ways and maybe not come back. Here's another shot in the water tank. And again, we also tether our tools. You can hardly see it here, but there's some tools that I'm using, and I have tethers that are on my wrists that I tether to the tools. Now, when we're doing a spacewalk in space, there's lots of aids we have. The yellow things you see in the picture are called handrails, and that's how we move around. We also have what are called foot restraints. I don't see one in this picture. But you can almost see the tether there in, over here in the suit. So just when we're doing a spacewalk, we also wear tethers. Now, on my second mission, I mentioned I did three spacewalks, and one of them was kind of famous because, A, it turned out to be a long spacewalk, 8 hours and 29 minutes, which is the second longest spacewalk in history, and that was with Rick Hebe and Tom Akers, who I did that spacewalk with. But the more important thing is it's the only three-person spacewalk that has ever happened. And Rick and I and Tom were grabbed this satellite with a lot of help from the crew members inside and the mission control team on the on ground. We eventually repaired the satellite and it sent us on its way. So, S is for spacewalking. It's a lot of fun to do a spacewalk. It takes a lot of hard work and a lot of study, but it really is very rewarding. And I hope you enjoyed this little talk about spacewalks.